हेलो, आई एम नवीन सर, योर मैथ्स टीचर. आप काकतिया पब्लिक स्कूल. यस्टरडे वी डिस्कस्ड अलजेब्रा एक्सप्रेशंस, हायर ऑर्डर थिंकिंग प्रॉब्लम्स वी डिस्कस्ड. टुडे वी विल रिवाइज द रिवीजन ऑफ अलजेब्रा एक्सप्रेशंस. वी विल रिवाइज द टोटल टॉपिक ऑफ अलजेब्रा एक्सप्रेशंस. Variable. A variable takes different value. Its value is not fixed. We will use the alphabetical letters A, B, C, so on, Z to represent variables. So variable is nothing but it takes different value. It does not stand on fixed value. So we will use these alphabetical letters to represent variable. Now constant, second one, constant is nothing but it stands on a fixed value. It does not change at any cost. So we use numbers 0 to 9 to represent constant. Variables will not will change, but constant will not change. It is fixed value. It does not a fixed value. So simultaneously it will change the value, but this constant is a fixed value. So we will use 0 to 9 numbers to represent constant. We will use alphabetical order letters to represent to use a variable. Next, term. Term is nothing but a variable or a constant or product of variable and constant is called as a term. So variable nothing but x or constant 9 or product of variable and constant 9 gets 9x. So this is also called as a term. So term is nothing but a variable or a constant, and product of a variable and constant is called a term. So terms are two types, like terms and unlike terms. Terms are two types. First one is a like terms. So the terms which have same variable with the same exponent are called like terms. For example, 2x, 3x, and 2y square, 3y square, like this. Variable is what? X, same variable. What is the exponent? 1. With same variable, with same exponent. So this type of terms are called like terms. So here variable y and exponent is 2, same variable and exponent which terms have same variables with the same exponent are called like terms. Now second one, unlike terms. The terms which have same variable but not the same exponent are the terms which have same exponent but variables are not same are called unlike terms. For example, 2x, 3y. Here exponent is same but variables are different. Then these are called unlike terms. 2x square 3 y square. So here also exponent is same, but variables are different. These are unknown terms. And one more example. 3z and 4z square. 3z and 4z square. So here variable is same, but exponent here 1, here 2. Then this type of terms are called as unknown terms. Now expression. So an expression we can treat as a single term or combination of terms connecting by symbols plus and minus. So an expression is a, we can treat as a, we can say as a single term, a term or combination of terms also. For example, 5xyz. So 5xyz, it is a single term. So this also we can say as an expression, or 5x plus yz. 5x plus yz. So here the terms are the combination of terms which, like, we are connecting the terms by using symbols plus and minus. So 5x plus yz, like 5x minus yz. So the terms are connecting with the symbols using symbols plus and minus are also called expression. So expression is nothing but single terms or combination of terms connecting by symbols plus and minus are called expression. So here only the symbol plus and minus can separate the terms. One note here, but multiplication, division cannot separate the terms. Multiplication, division cannot separate the terms. So let us take one example, 2x into 3y. So this, we are multiplying two terms, 2 into 3, 6, x into y, xy. So we will write it as a single term. So multiplication and division cannot separate the terms, they will treat as a single terms. For example, 2x divided by 3y, then we will write as a 2x by 3y. Then it is also a single term. So in expression, the terms only separated by using symbols plus and minus. We can't separate the terms by using multiplication and division. Now next, these expressions are two types. Expressions are two types. First one is numerical expressions. Numerical expressions. If an expression consists of every term is a number or constant, then it is called as a numerical expression. So an expression consists of each and every term is a constant, then it is called as a numerical expression. For example, 2 plus 3 minus 5. So this is an expression. So terms, every term is not a constant, then this type of expressions are called numerical expressions. Now second one, algebraic expressions. Algebraic expressions. If an expression consists at least one variable, one algebraic term, then it is called an algebraic expression. For example, 2x plus 4. For example, 2x plus 4. So this is an expression. It has a variable. Then it is called an algebraic expression. So this is the expression. Expression is nothing but single term or combination of terms connecting by
symbols plus and minus is called an expression. So not only the symbols plus and minus we can separate the terms, but multiplication, division, we can't separate the terms. Now expressions are two types: numerical expression, so and algebraic expression. So here numerical expression, nothing but if an expression consists of each and every term is a constant, then we can say the expression is a numerical expression. Algebraic expression, in an expression consists of at least one variable, then the expression is called as an algebraic expression. Now types of algebra expressions. Types of algebraic expressions. So here different types of algebraic expressions are there: monomial, binomial, trinomial, and multinomial. So first one is a monomial. If an expression consists only single term, then it is called as a monomial. Mono, single. So if an expression consists of single term, then it is called as a monomial algebraic expression. For example, 6xy. So this is also an expression. Single term also will treat as an expression. So this single term is called as a monomial. And second one, binomial. If an expression consists of two unlike terms, if an expression consists of two unlike terms, then the expression is called as a binomial algebraic expression. For example, 5x plus 4. So here, this expression consists of how many terms? Two terms. So this is a algebraic term, this is a numerator. Then it is called a binomial algebraic expression. Now third one, trinomial algebraic expression. If an expression consists of three unlike terms, not a like terms. If you are taking like terms, we can make as a single term. That's why we are taking three unlike terms. So, for example, 5x plus 4y plus z. So, if an expression consists of three unlike terms, then the given expression is called as a trinomial. And fourth one, multinomial. If an expression consists of single term, at least more than single term, nothing but 2, 3, 4, so multinomial is nothing but if an expression consists of more than one term is called multinomial. For example, 5x plus 4 we can take as a multinomial, and 5x plus 4y plus z we can treat as a multinomial. So here note, binomial, trinomial we can say as a multinomial. So binomial, trinomial are also called as a multinomial. So multinomial definition one more time. If an expression consists of more than one term or at least two terms, then it is called as a multinomial. So we can treat binomial and trinomial are also called multinomial. So these are the types of algebraic expressions. Next, equation. An the equation consisted, we will write as two expressions. So here 5x and 4, these two expressions we are writing with, connecting with equal sign. Connecting with equal sign, it is called an equation. So the equation has two parts. It is they are LHS and RHS. LHS and RHS. LHS nothing but left hand side. RHS is nothing but right hand side. So look at here equal sign. Equal sign this side, 5x, this side. So this is my left hand. Then 5x is LHS and is equal sign this side. For equal sign this side 4. So it is located on the RHS. Then 4 is RHS. So 5x is LHS, 4 is RHS. Now simple equation. An equation consists of one variable with degree 1. An equation consists of one variable, at least one variable with degree 1 is called simple equation. For example, 6x plus 4 is equals to 8. So here, how many variables are there? One variable, at least one variable with degree 1. With degree 1 is called simple equation. So simple equation is nothing but an equation has one variable with degree 1 is called simple equation. So simple equation also has two parts. One is LHS and another one is RHS. So this is called as LHS and this is called RHS. This is called LHS and this is called RHS. Now degree of algebraic expression. Degree of algebraic expression. The degree is nothing but the highest exponent of an expression of all terms is called the degree of algebraic expression. Highest exponents of all terms of a given expression is called the degree of algebraic expression. So I am writing an expression 5xy plus yz is equals to 4. I get one expression. So this 5xy plus yz, I get this expression. Now we have to find out the degree. So we have to calculate the exponent of single terms. So this is the term exponent. X has exponent 1, y has exponent 1. Then add is, then total exponent of this term is 2. So here, yes, y has exponent 1, z also exponent is 1. Then total is exponent is 2. Then what is the exponent of this highest exponent of this algebra expression is 2. Then the degree of algebra expression is what? 2. The degree of algebra expression is what? 2. So here another example, 7x plus 4 y square, I return. So here x is exponent 1 and y is exponent 2. So which is the highest exponent here? 2. Then the degree of this algebra expression is what? 2. The degree of algebra expression of this what? 2. So this is the degree of algebra expression, nothing but highest exponent of all terms of a given expression is called as a degree of algebra expression. Degree of constant term. Degree of constant term. So then let us take one constant term as a seventh. So constant nothing but number 0 to 9. So let us take one constant 7 I took. So this by using the law of exponents we can write, we know that x power 0 is equals to 1. So let us write 7 into x power 0, nothing but 7x power 0. I'm multiplying with variable x power 0, nothing but 7 into x power 0, nothing but 7 into 1, again it will remain same. Yes or not? Then the degree of constant term is what? 0. The degree of constant term is what? 0. So here let us take the constant 7, and by using law of exponents, x power 0 we know a power 0 is equals to 1. We can apply for any variable x power 0 is equals to 1. So let us write like this: 7 into x power 0, nothing but 7x power 0. So x power 0 nothing but 1. Then the degree, so it is a constant. This 7 I am writing as a 7x power 0 I am writing. Then what we can say, 7 is a constant. It has degrees how much? 0. It has degrees how much? 0. Then the degree of constant term is what? 0. Next, coefficient. So let us take one term that is 6xy. So here 6 is coefficient of xy. 6 is coefficient of xy and x is coefficient of 6y and y is coefficient of 6x. So every number and variable is a coefficient. So but in this coefficient we can define two types. 6 is called as a numerical coefficient. Then here 6 is called as a numerical coefficient, and this x and y are called as a literal coefficients. So 6 is called as a numerical number, nothing but numerical coefficient. X and y variables are called as a literal coefficients. Literal coefficients. So here coefficient is nothing but, let us take one example, 6xy. 6 is a coefficient of xy, you can write it, and x is a coefficient of 6y, and y is a coefficient of 6x. So here every numeral and variable is a coefficient, but number numeral is called as a numerical coefficient, variables are called as a literal coefficients. So paper pattern, it has two parts, part A and part B. Part A is 70 marks, part B is 10 marks. Part B is totally fill in the blanks, part A is totally you should answer the following problems. Part A and part B, this is 70 marks and this is 10 marks. So total 80 marks. Now we will discuss about the problems. First problem, this type of problems will come for 2 marks. So identify the like terms. Here different types of terms are there. We have to identify the like terms. Like terms. Nothing but the terms which have a same variable with the same exponent. So look at here, with a variable x with exponent 2. So first I am writing 8x square. With variable x with exponent 2, is there any like terms? Yes, 11x square. Yes, with variable x and exponent 2. Yes, 11x square. And more, yes, here with variable x and exponent 2, 25x square. So x square terms, like terms are finished. Now xy terms, more than xy terms, yes, here 5xy and here minus 4xy, these are like terms. More any xy terms? No, not there. Next, only y term is there. Any y terms? No, not there. Except only single term. So these are the like terms. See, same variable with the same exponent. See, same variables with the same exponents. These are the like terms. Now, second problem. This type of problems will come for 4 marks. Write the following expressions in statements. So the given expressions we have to write in the statements. Solution. First, A, x plus 5. So this expression we should write in the statement. So x is more than 5. Or 5 more than x. Or 5 is added to x. Two times we can write. So 5 more than x. Or 5 is added to x. So 5 is added to x. Next B. Y minus 8. What do you mean? Subtracting. How much? 8. From where? From y. So 8 is subtracted from y. 8 is subtracted from y. 8 is subtracted from y. Now see 12p. So what are you doing here? Multiplying. So p is multiplied by 12. P is multiplied by 12. Next up, D. What are you doing here? Z by 6. Then 6 is what doing? Dividing. What your Z? So Z is divided by 6. Z is divided by 6. So like this, following expressions we should write in the statements. Now third problem. This type of problems will come for 8 marks. Solution. Here they are given 3 expressions. Expression A, expression B and expression C. So we have to find the values of A plus B minus C, and second one is A minus 2B. First we have to write first step. We should write the expressions and between them plus and minus symbols. First, x square plus 3y square minus 4xy. After expression A, we should keep plus. Then expression B, 2y square plus 8x square plus 4xy. Expression after B, minus. Then after expression C, 3x square plus 4y square plus 2xy. Now we have to simplify. So first expression we should write as it is. x square plus 3y square minus 4xy. Now we have to multiply with plus. Plus into plus, plus 2y square plus 8x square plus 4xy. Now here we have to multiply with minus. Minus into plus, minus 3x square. Minus into plus, minus 4y square. Minus into plus, minus 2xy. Now we have to rearrange the like terms together. First, x square terms we should write together. Here x square term, here x square term, and here x square term. So x square plus 8x square and minus 3x square. Next, y square terms. Here 3y square, 2y square, and minus 4y square. So plus 3y square plus 2y square and remaining minus 4y square. Y square terms are finished. Now we should write the xy terms. Minus 4xy and plus 4xy and remaining minus 2xy. Now we have to simplify the coefficients. Here what are you got? 1. 1 plus 8, 9. 9 minus 3, 6. Then 6x square. So what are we doing here? We are simplifying the coefficients. So nothing but 1 here. So 1 plus 8, how much? 9. 9 minus 3, how much? 6. 6x square. Now here, y square terms. 3 plus 2, 5. 5 minus 4, how much? 1. Nothing but plus y square. Plus 1, y square, nothing but y square will write. Now, xy terms. Here, minus 4xy plus 4xy is equals to 0. That gets cancelled. The remaining is what? Minus 2xy. Now, second one, a minus 2b. So, first let us write expression a. X square plus 3y square minus 4xy minus 2 into b. Expression b is 2y square plus 8x square plus 4xy. So now first expression we should write as it is. X square plus 3y square minus 4xy. Now let us multiply with minus 2. Minus into plus, minus 2 are 4y square. Now next, minus into plus, minus 2 8s are 16x square. Now minus into plus, minus 2 4s are 8xy. Now rearrange the like terms together. First, x square terms. X square and 16x square minus 16x square. Next, y square and y square. There's 3y square minus 4y square plus 3y square minus 4y square. Next, xy terms. Minus 4xy minus 8xy. So here plus minus means what we have to do? Minus. From 16x square, 1x square gone. The remaining 15x square, which is the value of 16. 16 has which sign? It's symbol minus. And we should keep minus. Now here, less than minus means different. Two different signs we have to subtract. From 4, 3 subtracted. How much? Only 1y square, which is being 4. 4 has minus. And we should keep minus. So here, both are minus. Minus to minus, plus. Means we have to add. So 4 plus 8 is how much? 12 x y. So which is been here? 8. Then 8 is minus symbol, minus. So like this we have to simplify. This type of problem will come for 8 marks. I hope you understood. Thank you.